हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू प्रशांत आईएएस। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द पावर्स ऑफ द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया एंड इन दिस क्लास वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन फर्दर। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट आवर डिस्कशन विद द नोशंस इन द पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट। ओके, सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज नोशंस इन द पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट। सो फ्रेंड्स, द फर्स्ट नोशन इज प्राइम मिनिस्टीरियल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टीरियल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट। ओके, सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टीरियल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट। सो फ्रेंड्स, आई विल गिव यू वन एग्जाम्पल एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट एग्जाम्पल आई विल ट्राई टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट वेरी इजिली। सो फ्रेंड्स, here on the screen you can see a diagram of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. So in the upper pink circle I have represented Rajya Sabha and in the lower bigger and blue circle I have represented Lok Sabha. Friends, till now I have explained you many time the process of the formation of government in India, means how the government is formed in India. And now I hope that you all must be very clear with the process of the formation of government, means how the government is formed in India. Okay, so friends, now let's move further. Now friends, we all know that there are many political parties in India. Okay, so we all know that there is party politics in India. So what is the meaning of party politics? So party politics means when political parties contest the election. Okay, so there are many political parties in India. So let's suppose friends, in this example we will assume that there are four political parties in India: political party A, political party B, political party C and political party D. Now friends, in the previous lectures I have told you that how many members are there in Lok Sabha. So I have told you that there are total 543 members in Lok Sabha. How many members are there in Lok Sabha? There are total 543 members in Lok Sabha. And in India, government is formed through Lok Sabha elections. In India, government is formed through Lok Sabha elections. Means the party which will get absolute majority in Lok Sabha, that party will form the government. In yesterday's class also, I have explained you this concept that the political party which will get absolute majority in Lok Sabha, okay, the political party which will get absolute majority in Lok Sabha, that political party will form the government, means that political party will form the council of ministers. Okay, so that political party will form the government who will get absolute majority in Lok Sabha. Now friends, let's suppose that in any Lok Sabha election, okay, so here we are talking about Lok Sabha election. So in any Lok Sabha election, let us assume that political party A got 150 seats, political party B got 130 seats, political party C got 100 seats and political party D got 163 seats. And when you will sum up all these numbers, then the number will come as 543. So 543 are the total number of seats in Lok Sabha, okay, or the total membership of Lok Sabha. Okay, so we can use both of these terms alternatively: total number of seats in Lok Sabha or total membership of Lok Sabha, because definitely it is a common sense that one member will occupy one seat. So one member is equivalent to one seat. Okay, so these are the results of a Lok Sabha election. Okay, so what happened in a Lok Sabha election? That political party A got 150, B got 130, C got 100 and D got 163 seats. Now friends, just now I have told you that to form the government, any political party needs absolute majority in Lok Sabha. Now what is the meaning of absolute majority? So absolute majority means more than 50% of the total membership of the house. Okay, so what is absolute majority? So absolute majority means more than 50% of the total membership of the house. Now what is the total membership of Lok Sabha? So total membership of Lok Sabha is 543 एंड द 50% ऑफ 543 हाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट, सो वी विल मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 50 अपॉन 100, ओके, सो वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई 543 बाय 50 अपॉन 100, सो व्हेन यू विल डू ऑल द कैलकुलेशंस देन द रिजल्ट विल कम एज 271.5, सो इट मींस दैट एंड वी नीड अ नंबर विच इज मोर देन 271.5, सो विच नंबर इज मोर देन 271.5, सो डेफिनेटली 272 इज द नंबर विच इज मोर देन 271.5, means any political party who will get 272 or more than that seats in Lok Sabha, that party will form the government. Now friends, if you will check here, okay, so political party A got only 150 seats, which is less than 272, B got 130 seats, which is less than 272, C got 100 seats, less than 272, and D got 163 seats, which is also less than 272. So friends, even though political party D got 163 seats, but it is very less than 272. 163 is less than 272. Okay, so it means that no political party got the absolute majority in Lok Sabha. No political party got the absolute majority in Lok Sabha. So now the question is that how the government will be formed. Okay, so this is something newer to you all, that how the government will be formed. So please pause the video and think for 2 minutes that in this situation, how the government will be formed. So friends, now I will give you the answer. So as we can see that political party D got 163 seats. Okay, so we can say that political party D is a major political party. Major political party means it has a very good presence in the country. It has a very good vote share in the country. Okay, so in simple words, we can say that political party D is a big political party. Now, after political party D, political party A got second highest votes. Okay, so how many votes party A got? So party A got 150 votes. So definitely we can conclude that political party A is also a big political party. But none of them can form the government alone. Why? Because none of them have 272 or more than seats in Lok Sabha. And for forming the government, at least 272 or more than that seats are needed in Lok Sabha. So now what these political parties can do? Okay, so these are 4 political parties: party A, party B, party C and party D. So now these political parties can join hands together to form the government. Okay, means they can form the government in partnership. They can enter into a partnership and they can form the government. Okay, so now let's suppose friends that political party A got 150 seats. Okay, and definitely by seeing the results, you can say that the biggest rival of political party A is political party D, because political party D even got more than votes than political party A. Okay, so now let's suppose that the leader of political party A approached to the leader of political party B. And leader of political party A gave a proposal to the leader of political party B that you can join hands with me and then we will rule together. Then we will together form the government. Okay. Now friends, here you can see that political party C is not that important. Why? Because if political party D and political party C joins hands together. Okay. So let's assume that if political party D and political party C joins hands together, then what will be the result? So D got 163 seats and C got 100 seats. So if you will add both these, then the result will come as 263. And the number 263 is less than 272. Okay. Now friends, if political party A joins hands with political party C, so A got 150 seats and how many seats C got? C got only 100 seats. Okay, A got 150 seats and C got 100 seats, so result will come as 250. Now this number 250 is also less than 272. Means neither political party A can form the government nor political party D can form the government by joining hands with C. ओके, बिकॉज सी ओनली हैज, सी हैज द लीस्ट नंबर ऑफ वोट्स. सो इवन इफ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी ए जॉइंस हैंड्स विद पॉलिटिकल पार्टी सी, देन ऑल्सो इट कैन नॉट फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट. सिमिलरली इफ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी डी जॉइंस द हैंड्स विद पॉलिटिकल पार्टी सी, देन पॉलिटिकल पार्टी, देन ऑल्सो पॉलिटिकल पार्टी डी कैन नॉट फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट. सो वॉट कंक्लूजन वी कैन ड्रॉ फ्रॉम दिस स्टोरी? सो वी कैन ड्रॉ कंक्लूजन दैट पॉलिटिकल पार्टी सी डू नॉट हैव any importance in the formation of the government. Why? Because even after joining hands with any other political party, they will not be able to form the government. So here we will ignore political party C. Okay? So I have told you this because now we will ignore political party C. Why? Because even if political party A and political party B or political party C, sorry, political party A, political party B or political party D joins hands with political party C, then also they will not be able to form the government. Now friends, here the most important political party is political party B. Now why political party B is most important? Political party B is most important because D got 163 seats and A got 150 seats. So by seeing the results of the election, you can say that political party A and political party D are the main rival parties. They are the main rival parties. So political party D also wants to form the government and political party A also wants to form the government. Okay. Now let's suppose if political party A joins hands with political party B. Okay. Now A has 150 seats, B has 130 seats, and when their seats will be summed up, so the result will come as 280. Now this number 280 is more than 272. So if A and B will join the hands together, then definitely they will be able to form the government. Now friends, political party D got 163 seats and political party B got 130 seats. So if D and B joins the hands together, then they will have 293 votes. Okay, so definitely 293 is more than 293 is more than 272. So they will be able to form the government together. So here the conclusion of this story is the political party B is the most important political party. Why? Because because political party A wants to join hands with political party B. Similarly, political party D also wants to join hand with political party B. Okay. Political party A also want to join hand with political party B. And political party D also want to join hand with political party B. So now what will happen in this situation? That the leader of political party A will approach to the leader of political party B. And he will put a proposal in front of the leader of political party B. Similarly, the leader of political party D will approach to the leader of political party B. And he will also put a proposal to the leader of political party B. Now friends, it is up to the leader of political party B that whose proposal he want to accept. Okay. So it is up to the wish of leader of political party B. So if he wants to join hands with A, then he is free to do so. And if he wants to join hands with D, then he is also free to do so. Now friends, let's suppose that the leader of political party A is more prudent. Okay, he is more cunning person. So what leader of political party A did? He put a better proposal in front of the leader of political party B. And finally, what happened? That political party A and political party B joined their hands together. Okay, political party A and political party B joined their hands together. So political party A got 150 seats and B got 130 seats. So now together they have 280 seats, means now they can form the government. And this type of government is known as coalition government. Okay, so this type of government is known as coalition government. So coalition government means when no single political party gets majority in Lok Sabha. Okay, so no single political party gets majority in Lok Sabha. So two or more than two. Okay, this number can be more than two. So two or more than two political parties join hands together and together they forms the government. So this type of government is known as coalition government. Okay. Now friends, let's see further. Okay. So till now I have told you that political party A got 150 seats and political party B got 130 seats. They joined hands together and together they had 280 seats. So they formed the government. Okay. So now the government is formed. Now friends, here we can see that political party A has more seats एंड पॉलिटिकल पार्टी बी हैज लेस सीट्स. ओके, सो हियर बिग पार्टी इज पॉलिटिकल पार्टी ए एंड पॉलिटिकल पार्टी बी इज स्मॉल पॉलिटिकल पार्टी. सो नाउ व्हाट प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया विल डू, नाउ व्हाट प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया विल डू, नाउ ही विल कॉल द लीडर ऑफ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी ए टू फॉर्म द गवर्नमेंट एंड टू बिकम द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स suppose that the leader of political party A became the prime minister of India. Okay, so the leader of political party A became the prime minister of India. Now friends, in yesterday's class I have told you that after a person, means after the leader of a political party is appointed as the prime minister by the president, then he chooses his ministers. Okay, so let's suppose he is the prime minister. Now what he will do? Now he will choose his ministers. Okay, so friends, let's suppose that now friends, he has to choose ministers from both political parties, his own political party as well as from political party B. Okay, so he has to choose ministers from political party A and as well as political party B. Why? Because if he will not choose ministers from political party B, then political party B will take back his support. Okay, then political party will say that I am not in partnership with political party A. And if the political party B takes back its support, then definitely government will form. Government will fall. Okay, so if political party B takes back its support from political party A, then definitely government will fall. So now what this PM means here the leader of political party A, what he has to do? Now he has to elect ministers from political party A as well as political party B. Okay, so means in council of ministers, ministers will be from both political parties, political party A as well as political party B. Now friends, the leader and the members of political party A will exert a pressure, will pressurize political party A to give important ministries. Okay, so definitely it is a common sense that political party A has more number of seats, so the leader of political party A will become the prime minister. But now the leader and the members of political party B will pressurize this prime minister. Okay, so they will pressurize this prime minister to give all the other important ministerial positions to the members of political party A. For example, leader of political party B can demand that I want to become the home minister. Okay, and if you will not appoint me as the home minister, then definitely sir, I will take back my support. And if I will take back my support, then your government will fall. So now prime minister under pressure, he has to give home ministry to the leader of political party B. Let's suppose there is a very other, this person is another influential person of political party B. So now this person is saying that prime minister sir, if you will not give me finance ministry, then definitely my party will take back its support from you. So you have to give me the post of finance ministry. So now PM under pressure has to give him the charge of finance ministry. Okay, now friends, let's see further. Now friends, we all know that there are many states in India. Okay, and the political parties which fights the election, which contest the election in the country, these political parties also contest the election in the states. Okay, so the same political parties forms the government in states as well as the country. Okay, so means the political party which will win the election in state, they will form the government in state, or the political party which will win the election in center, so they will form the government at center. Okay, so here I want to explain that there are same political parties. Okay, so for example, we have taken the example of four political parties: political party A, political party B, political party C and political party D. Okay, so political party A got 150 seats, political party B got 130 seats, political party C got 100 seats and political party D got 163 seats. Now friends, we all know that political party A and political party B joined hands together and they form the government. Okay, so means there is the government of the coalition of political party A and political party B in the country. There is the government of coalition of political party A and political party B in the country. And whose leader is prime minister? So the leader of political party A is the prime minister. Now friends, let's suppose there is a state. So here we will assume, okay, so we know that there are many states in India. For example, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Telangana, कर्नाटका, तमिलनाडु, ओके, केरला, हिमाचल प्रदेश, हरियाणा, सो देर आर मेनी स्टेट्स इन इंडिया. बट हेयर आई विल नॉट टेक द नेम ऑफ एनी स्टेट, हेयर वी विल इमेजिन एनी हाइपोथेटिकल स्टेट, ओके, एनी इमेजिनरी स्टेट. सो लेट सपोज द नेम ऑफ एनी स्टेट इज स्टेट एक्स, ओके, सो द नेम ऑफ एनी स्टेट इज स्टेट एक्स. नाउ फ्रेंड्स, लेट सपोज दैट पॉलिटिकल पार्टी डी इज रूलिंग इन स्टेट एक्स, ओके, पॉलिटिकल पार्टी डी इज रूलिंग इन स्टेट एक्स, मीन्स देर इज द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी इन स्टेट एक्स. नाउ फ्रेंड्स, वॉट हैपन्ड इन स्टेट एक्स, दैट द गवर्नमेंट इन स्टेट एक्स वॉज नॉट वर्किंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोविजन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, ओके. सो द वॉट हैपन्ड दैट द गवर्नमेंट इन द स्टेट एक्स, गवर्नमेंट इन द स्टेट एक्स वॉज नॉट वर्किंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोविजन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, मीन्स दे वर नॉट ओबेइंग द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, दे वर डूइंग वॉट वॉज कमिंग इन टू देयर माइंड्स, और दे वर रूलिंग आर्बिट्ररीली, ओके. सो वी कैन से दैट दे वर रूलिंग आर्बिट्ररीली, और वी कैन से दैट दे वर नॉट फॉलोइंग द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन द रूलिंग ऑफ द कंट्री. सो इफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ एनी स्टेट, if the government of any state is not following the provisions of the constitution, then we can say that constitutional machinery has failed in that state, okay. So we can say that constitutional machinery has failed in the state. Now friends, according to article 356 of the Indian constitution, if the constitutional machinery has failed in a state, then president can impose the precedent rule on that state, okay. Then president can impose precedent rule on that state, okay. Now friends, president needs the advice of Union Council of Ministers. Now friends, here I have told you that there is the coalition government of political party A and political party B in the country, okay. And definitely political party A and political party B, both rival parties, political party D. And who is the boss of Council of Ministers? So I have told you that Prime Minister is the boss of Council of Ministers. So friends, now when Prime Minister will ask the members of Council of Ministers for the imposition of President's rule in State X, okay. So now what Prime Minister will say to the members of Council Minister, that we have to impose President's rule in state X. So definitely all of them will agree. Why? Because Council of Ministers is either having the members of political party A or members of political party B, and both of them are rival of political party D, and there is a government of political party D in the state X, okay. So the members of both the political parties will agree on the PM's suggestion, okay, that we have to impose president's rule in state X, okay. So now the entire COM will give advice to the president of India, okay. So now entire Council of Ministers will give advice to the president of India to impose the president's rule in state X, and then president will impose the president's rule in state X, and state X will come under president's rule, okay. Now friends let's suppose that there is another state known as state Y, okay. So there is a state known as state Y, and party B is ruling in state Y, means there is the government of party B in state Y. Now friends, the same condition is in state Y, means the constitutional machinery has failed in state Y also, okay. So the constitutional machinery is failed in state Y also. So now what Prime Minister will do? Now Prime Minister will talk about the imposition of president's rule in state Y also, okay. So now Prime Minister will call the meeting of Council of Ministers, and in the meeting of Council of Ministers there will be the ministers of political party A as well as political party B. So when Prime Minister will tell them about the imposition of president's rule in state Y, then definitely the members of political party will get agree, okay. But the members of political party will not get agree on the decision of imposition of president's rule in state Y. Why? Because there is the rule of political party B in state Y, okay. So the members of political party B will not get agree on the decision of the imposition of president's rule in state by on any condition. Now friends, let's suppose that Prime Minister is a very good person, okay, he is a very honest person, and Prime Minister is saying that no, स्टेट एक्स गॉट द पनिशमेंट, सो स्टेट वाई शुड ऑल्सो गॉट द पनिशमेंट. जस्टिस इज इक्वल फॉर ऑल. सो नाउ प्राइम मिनिस्टर इज सेइंग टू द मेंबर्स ऑफ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी बी दैट प्लीज गेट एग्री ऑन द डिसीजन ऑफ द इम्पोजिशन ऑफ प्रेसिडेंट्स रूल इन स्टेट वाई. सो नाउ व्हाट द मेंबर्स ऑफ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी बी से, नाउ दे विल प्रेशराइज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. ओके, दे विल प्रेशराइज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. ओके, सो हियर यू कैन सी दैट दे आर exerting the pressure on Prime Minister, and they will say that, sir, we are giving you a clear-cut warning that if you will impose President's rule in state by, then definitely we will take back our support. So with the government of state by, your government will also fall. You will also lose your post. You will also not remain the Prime Minister of the country. So now the members of political party B, the leader of political party B will pressurize the Prime Minister, and they will say that if you will impose President's rule in state by, then definitely we will take back our support and then your government will fall. So friends, now Prime Minister will not be able to impose President's rule in state by. So what conclusion we can draw from this story? So from this story, we can draw the conclusion that if the government is a coalition government, okay? So if a government is a coalition government, for example, in our example, there were two political parties, A and B, okay? So and the Prime Minister was the leader of political party A. Okay, so Prime Minister was the leader of political party A. So now on each and every issue, the members of political party B will pressurize the Prime Minister. The members of political party B will pressurize the Prime Minister, and they will not allow him to take the smooth decisions. Okay, so if there is any decision, and if Prime Minister is not acting according to the advice of the members of political party B, okay, so here let's not talk about the President's rule, let's talk about any decision. Okay, so there is any decision and Prime Minister is saying something else, but the members of political party B is saying something else. So in this situation also, the members of political party B will pressurize the Prime Minister that either you take decision what we are saying, otherwise we will take back our support, and once we will take back our support, then your government will fall and you will also fall. Okay, so what the members of political party B do, always every time they will pressurize the Prime Minister, and in this way Prime Minister will become very weak. Why Prime Minister will become weak? Prime Minister will become weak because he will not be able to take decisions by his own discretion. He will not be able to take decision by his own wish. Every time he has to satisfy the greed, he has to satisfy the wishes of the members of political party B. And if he will not satisfy the wishes of the members of political party B, then they will take back their support, and in the process, the government will fall. So every time PM is feared that if I will not satisfy their wishes, then they will take back their support. So in the process, Prime Minister will become very weak. Okay. Now friends, let us imagine another condition. So again, there are four political parties, political party A, B, C and D. This time political party D got 93 seats. Political party C got 100 seats in Lok Sabha election. Political party B got 50 seats in Lok Sabha election, and political party A got 300 seats in Lok Sabha election. And when you will sum up all these, so the result will come as 543, means the total number of seats in Lok Sabha. So political party A got 300, B got 50, C got 100 and D got 93 seats in Lok Sabha election. Now we know that only 272 seats are needed for forming the government in Lok Sabha, and political party A got 300 seats. So now it is clearly decided that political party A will form the government. Now friends, let's suppose that in the Lok Sabha election, okay, so now let's suppose that this is the political party A, okay, so this is political party A, and these all green dots are the members of political party A. Now friends, let's suppose that this big red dot, this person is the leader. Okay, this person is the leader of political party A. Now this leader is a very, very famous person. This people loves that leader. Okay, people want that this leader, this person should become the prime minister of the country. Okay, so there is a condition that this is the leader of the party. Okay, let's suppose his name is Mr. X. Okay, so his name is Mr. X. So Mr. X is a very famous person. People loves Mr. X. People wants that Mr. X should become the prime minister of the country. Okay, and in the party also all the people want that Mr. X should become the prime minister of the country. Okay, so what conclusion we can make through this story? So we can make a conclusion through this story that first of all Mr. X is the undisputed leader of party A, means nobody wants to become leader in the place of Mr. X. Nobody in the party wants to replace Mr. X. All the members of the party loves Mr. X. Okay, means Mr. X is the most assertive, most abled, most worthy person in the party A. Okay, so we can say that Mr. X is the undisputed leader of party A, means there is no dispute regarding his position. Everybody wants that he should become the prime minister. Okay, so this is the first condition, that he is undisputed leader of party A. Now second condition is that people loves Mr. X, and people want that we will give our vote to Mr. X if Mr. X will become the prime minister of the country. So people are saying that we will only give our vote to political party A if Mr. X will become the prime minister. Now what does it mean? It means that Mr. X is actually bringing victory to their party. Okay, means it is the efforts of Mr. X which are bringing victory to the political party A. Okay, so people are giving votes to all the MPs, all the candidates in the name of Mr. X. So we can conclude that Mr. X has bought victory to political party A. And definitely we can see that the third condition is that there is a majority of political party A. Okay, so there is an absolute majority of political party A, means there is no coalition government. Political party A has absolute majority in Lok Sabha. So friends, if these three conditions are satisfied, then what will happen? Okay, so let's see, if these three conditions are satisfied, then what will happen? Now friends, here on the screen I have drawn the diagram of Council of Ministers. So I have told you that political party A got 300 seats. So political party A forms the government. So it is decided that now political party A will form the government. And who will become prime minister? So the leader of political party, means Mr. X, will become the prime minister. So now this is the Council of Ministers. Okay, so this black rectangle is Council of Ministers. This green rectangle is cabinet. All these black dots are ministers, and all these green dots are cabinet ministers, and this big red dot is Mr. X, means the prime minister. Okay, now friends, I have told you three conditions. My first condition was that Mr. X is the undisputed leader of political party A. Okay, means he is the undisputed leader of political party A. Second thing, that he has bought victory to his party in the Lok Sabha election. Okay, and third condition is that the party has absolute majority in Lok Sabha. Party has absolute majority in Lok Sabha. So the first condition is satisfied. Party has absolute majority in Lok Sabha, and Mr. X is the undisputed leader. So this is also satisfied. And I have told you that people loves Mr. X. So he bought victory to his political party. Now friends, what will happen in this condition? That you just apply your mind and think that all these members, okay, all these members are, who are they? They are actually the, all these members of Council of Ministers, actually they are the members of political party A. Okay, so definitely prime minister will choose the members of his own political party. So they all are the members of political party A. Okay, moreover, all the cabinet ministers are also the members of political party A. And I have told you that he was the undisputed leader of his political party, means everybody respects him. Everybody, obeys his decisions. Everybody obeys his orders. Okay. Moreover, when he brought victory to his political party, then his respect will increase. Okay. Why? Because now these members will think that actually he is a very assertive person. He is a very powerful person. So his respect will increase. Okay. And moreover, party has absolute majority in Lok Sabha. So definitely all these members definitely belong to political party A. Okay. So there is no problem like that of in coalition government. So now friends, what will happen in this condition? That this type of government is now known as prime ministerial form of government. Why? Because now in this condition, whatever this prime minister will say, okay, now in this condition, whatever prime minister will say, cabinet will accept it and entire council of ministers will also accept it. Okay, so prime minister will take decision and his decisions will be accepted by cabinet as well as council of ministers. Means we can say that in this condition, prime minister will dominate the cabinet and council of ministers. Okay, so in this condition, prime minister will dominate the cabinet as well as council of ministers. Okay, so why? Because definitely prime minister is the undisputed leader. He brought victory to his party. His party is absolute majority. So whatever decision, so he has a big respect in country as well as in council of ministers and in cabinet. So whatever decision he will take, so the members of cabinet and the members of council of minister will think that he is a very strong person. He is a very intelligent person. So if he has taken any decision, then that decision must be right. So his decisions will be accepted. His policies will be accepted by all the members of cabinet as well as all the members of council of ministers blindly. Okay, means in this condition, prime minister dominates the cabinet and council of ministers. No single minister, whether he is a cabinet minister or he is a minister of state or deputy minister, or okay, no minister has the power to oppose the decision of prime minister. Okay, even the group of ministers do not have the power to oppose the decision of prime minister because he is a very assertive person. So in this condition, prime minister will dominate the cabinet and decisions will be taken by prime minister and entire cabinet as well as COM will accept the decisions. So this type of government is known as prime ministerial form of government. So prime ministerial form of government means the government in which prime minister dominates the cabinet. Okay. Now friends, let us discuss about the pros and cons of the prime ministerial form of government, means the merits and demerits of the prime ministerial form of government. So first of all, we will discuss about the pros, means the merits of the prime ministerial form of government. Now friends, I have told you that cabinet is council of ministers is a very big body. Okay, and council of ministers is a very big body. Okay, council of ministers is a very big body. That's why a compact and a little body within council of ministers known as cabinet takes decision on behalf of entire takes decisions on behalf of entire council of ministers. Okay, so I have told you that council of ministers is a very big body, and because council of ministers is a big body, so what is the problem if council of ministers is a big body? What was the problem? So the problem which I have told you was that if there are many members, okay, if there are many members, so what some members will do, some members will be busy in gossiping, some members will be taking tea and snacks, okay, and some members will not pay their attention, some members will make noise. So in this condition, healthy debate and discussion will not be conducted, okay, and country will not get good decision. So what happens, that cabinet is a body in which there are less number of members. These members are senior most ministers, most experienced ministers, okay, and because the body is a small body, members are less, so it is very easy to conduct healthy discussion and debate in the cabinet. Now friends, let's suppose that if there is any emergency condition, okay, let's suppose if any other external country has invaded India, okay, so any other external country has invaded India, means any other country has attacked on India, so definitely now a quick decision is needed. Okay, so any other country has attacked India, so in this condition a quick decision is needed. बट आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट कैबिनेट टेक्स ऑल द डिसीजंस. सो नाउ व्हाट प्राइम मिनिस्टर विल डू, नाउ प्राइम मिनिस्टर विल कॉल द कैबिनेट मीटिंग. ओके, सो नाउ सम मिनिस्टर्स विल से दैट सर वी हैव टू स्टार्ट अ वॉर अगेंस्ट दैट कंट्री, एंड सम मिनिस्टर विल से दैट नो 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 सर वी शुड नॉट स्टार्ट अ वॉर. व्हाट वी शुड डू, वी शुड talk with them, we should talk with the leaders of that country, and these ministers will start fighting with each other. Okay, these ministers will say that sir we should show that we are very powerful, and other ministers will say that sir we should not take any decisions just like that, we have to talk to the leaders of that country. And in this way what will happen, that our Indian army will wait for the orders of the leaders. Okay, and what can happen, definitely these attackers, these invaders can cause a huge loss of life and property to our country. So what I am trying to explain, that sometimes very quick decision making is needed. Okay, sometimes very quick decision making is needed. Now let's suppose a condition that there is prime ministerial form of government. Prime ministerial form of government means PM is taking all the decisions, and the decisions of PM are accepted by cabinet as well as this council of ministers. Okay, so now in this situation, if any other country has invaded India or attacked India, so now PM will think, now if PM thinks that it is good to attack that country, then what PM will do, PM will give orders to the army to attack that country. And if PM will think that it is better to talk with the leaders of that country, then PM will do that. Now what I want to explain here, that PM will take very quick decisions, because here decision are not taken by any discussion or debate. Okay, there is only one person, and that one person is taking decision. So he will take a quick decision and he will implement that decision. So if army will get the orders to attack that country, so what will happen, that definitely army will attack that country and our property and lives will be saved. So quick decision making is a very big pro, or we can say that merit, of prime ministerial form of government. Now friends, let us discuss about the demerits or the cons of prime ministerial form of government. So here this green rectangle is cabinet and this black rectangle is council of ministers. Now friends, I have told you that council of ministers is collectively responsible to Lok Sabha. Now why council of ministers is collectively responsible to Lok Sabha? Because all the decisions are collectively taken by council of ministers. Okay, so actually all the decisions are taken by cabinet. All the decisions are collectively taken by cabinet ministers, and these decisions automatically becomes the decision of council of ministers. Okay, so what is the meaning of collective responsibility of council of ministers? So council of ministers is collectively responsible to Lok Sabha because all the decisions are taken collectively. All the decisions are taken collectively by all the members of council of ministers. Okay. Now friends, I have told you that cabinet takes all the decisions on behalf of council of ministers. So we can say that all the decisions are collectively taken by all the members of cabinet. Okay, all the decisions are collectively taken by all the members of cabinet. Now why decisions are taken collectively by the members of cabinet? Why decisions are taken collectively? Decisions are taken collectively because definitely one person may not be right all the time. One person may not be right all the time, even though he is very prudent, even though he is very intelligent, then also he can do mistakes. Why? Because to err is human. We are not God, we are humans, so we can commit mistakes. Okay, so individual persons can commit mistakes. Okay, now friends, let's suppose if only prime minister is taking decision, so prime minister is also a person. Okay, so it is a high possibility then he can commit mistake, and we cannot sacrifice the future of our country, we cannot sacrifice the all our people only by a wrong decision, due to a wrong decision taken by a person. Okay, we cannot sacrifice the future of our country due to a wrong decision taken by a person. So what happens in parliamentary form of democracy, parliamentary form of system, that decisions are collectively taken by council of ministers or cabinet. Okay, so cabinet takes decision on behalf of council of ministers, and decisions are taken collectively in cabinet. So what happens in decision making, that all the members of cabinet will discuss about any issue. Okay, so these all members will talk with each other and they will discuss about any issue, they will do debate. Okay, so for example, there is any issue, let's suppose if any other country has invaded India, सो ओके एनी अदर कंट्री हैज इन्वेडेड इंडिया. सो नाउ दिस ओके सॉरी लेट्स टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल द प्राइस ऑफ रेलवे फेयर. ओके मीन्स द प्राइस ऑफ ट्रेवलिंग इन रेल्स. ओके सो नाउ लेट्स सपोज दैट कैबिनेट हैज टू टेक अ डिसीजन रिगार्डिंग द रेलवे फेयर. नाउ फ्रेंड्स वॉट सम मिनिस्टर्स आर सेइंग. लेट्स सपोज दिस मिनिस्टर इज सेइंग दैट वी शुड इंक्रीज द फेयर. वाई? बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट इज गोइंग एंड रेलवे इज गोइंग इन लॉस. दिस मिनिस्टर इज सेइंग द सेम थिंग. बट लेट सपोज दैट दिस मिनिस्टर ओके सो दिस मिनिस्टर इज सेइंग नो सर इवन द रेलवे इज गोइंग इन लॉस देन ऑल्सो आर पीपल आर पुअर. इफ यू विल इंक्रीज द चार्जेस ऑफ रेलवे इफ यू विल इंक्रीज द फेयर ऑफ रेलवे देन मैनी पीपल विल नॉट बी एबल टू ट्रेवल. ओके सो ही गेव अ extraordinary or a different opinion. Now this minister is also saying that yes this person is right that people are poor they will not be able to travel in the they will not be able to travel. Okay now friends let's suppose again this minister is saying that no railway is going in loss and railway is also public property so we should increase the fares. Now again this minister is saying that no sir people if people are not able to afford then what is the use of railways. Okay so now what I want to explain is that in cabinet healthy discussion is going on. Okay so now all the merits and demerits of the decision will be discussed. Okay all the merits and demerits of the decision will be discussed and after entire discussion and debate a good decision will be taken. Okay so after entire discussion and debate a good decision is taken which is good for entire country as well as for the people of our country. Okay and let's suppose if a decision is to be taken by PM alone and if PM was of the opinion that we should increase the charges so definitely if the decision was to be taken by PM alone then PM will increase the charges and who will suffer? People will suffer. Okay people will suffer. They will not be able to travel through rails. So what I want to explain is that before taking any decision for such a big country, India is a very vast country. Okay, India is a very big country. There is huge diversity in India. Okay, and in Council of Ministers, there are many ministers from different places. The ministers also represent diversity. So ministers from different places, they can express their opinion. They can tell about the problems of their region. Okay, so if decision will be taken by many people, if decision will be taken by after a healthy debate and discussion, then decisions will be good and people will not suffer. Okay, so that's why decisions are taken collectively by Council of Ministers in parliamentary form of government. Okay, so this is the reason of collective responsibility of Council of Ministers towards Lok Sabha. So that Council of Ministers takes collective decision, and if decisions are collective, then decisions will be taken after a good debate and discussion. So decisions will be definitely good. Okay, so this is the reason why a Council of Ministers is collectively responsible to Lok Sabha or why Council of Ministers collectively take decision. Okay, but friends, if there is prime ministerial form of government, then definitely only Prime Minister is taking decision and then Prime Minister is imposing the decision on cabinet as well as Council of Ministers. So if only one person is taking decision, so it means that there is no debate, there is no discussion, means there is no guarantee whether the decision is good or not. There is no guarantee whether the decision is correct or not. Actually, Prime Minister has taken the decision and he has imposed the decision on the cabinet, Council of Ministers as well as entire country. Okay, so this is the biggest demerit, biggest con of the prime ministerial form of government, that there is no discussion, there is no debate, means decisions are not taken collectively. Decisions are not taken collectively in prime ministerial form of government. Decisions are not taken democratically in prime ministerial form of government. Okay, so in prime ministerial form of government, decisions are not taken democratically or collectively. So this is the biggest demerit or con of prime ministerial form of government. Now friends, what else can be the demerits or cons of prime ministerial form of government? Okay, so the next demerit or the con of prime ministerial form of government can be, okay, so it is a possibility that the decision taken by Prime Minister, okay? So it is a possibility that the decision taken by Prime Minister may also be to secure his political future rather than to meet the interest of the country. Okay, now what does it mean? It means that, let's suppose this person, Mr. X, okay, so here we had taken the example of Mr. X. So let's suppose Mr. X is the Prime Minister of India. Okay, now friends, let's suppose they all are the people of India. So this is the population of India. They are the people of India. Now let's suppose what happened, that Mr. X was a very popular leader. People loves him, but he took any decision and he implemented that decision. And what happened, that his decision went wrong. Okay, means that decision influenced many people. Many people died or many people suffered due to that decision. Okay, so Mr. X, the Prime Minister of India, he took any decision and his decision went wrong, and due to his wrong decision, many people suffered, many people faced problem, and now people hate Mr. X. Okay, now what people do? People hate Mr. X and people wants to remove Mr. X from his post. Now friends, court also ordered that Mr. X should leave his position. Why? Because he has done a wrong thing. So Mr. X should leave his position. Mr. X should resign from the post of Prime Minister. Now, as I have told you, that Mr. X is the leader of prime ministerial form of government, means he will take the decision. Okay, because now people are hating him, but earlier people loved him. When government was formed, people loved him. Now also he is the undisputed leader of his party. Now also his party is having absolute majority in Lok Sabha. Okay, so now also he is the leader of prime ministerial form of government. Now friends, what he can do? Okay, so I have told you that what happens in prime ministerial form of government, that prime minister takes the decision and he imposes his decisions on the cabinet as well as council of ministers. So cabinet and council of ministers has to accept his decisions. So now what can happen? This Mr. X will think that how to secure my position, how to secure my post. So now he will think that how to secure my post. So now he can even impose national emergency on the country. And once the national emergency is imposed, then now he don't have to leave his post. Now he doesn't have to leave his post. Okay. So he can even impose national emergency. And once the national emergency is imposed, then people will suffer more badly. Okay. Means the condition of people will become very bad. Okay, so he can impose national emergency and he will take the decision that now I am going to impose national emergency. So what he will do? He will tell his decision to cabinet and council of ministers. Okay, and then definitely council of ministers will give advice to the president and president will impose the national emergency. And once the national emergency is imposed, then this person, okay, once the national emergency is imposed, so I have told you that this government is the prime ministerial form of government. So prime minister will take the decision and cabinet and council of minister will accept his decision. So now prime minister will take the decision that we have to impose national emergency in the country. And what prime minister can do? Prime minister can force the cabinet to give advice to the president of India to impose the national emergency. And friends, we all know that President needs the written recommendation of the cabinet to impose the national emergency. Okay, so as this is a prime ministerial form of government, so this prime minister will take the decision and he will impose his decision on the cabinet and he will force the decision to give a written recommendation to the president of India to impose the national emergency. And once the cabinet will give in writing the advice to President of India to impose the national emergency, the national emergency will be imposed on the country and his political career is now secure. Okay, so now the political career of this Mr. X is now secure. So friends, we can conclude by this story that in prime ministerial form of government, it can happen that the person is not taking decisions in the interest of the country. Person is taking decision to secure his political career. Person is taking decisions to secure his own political career. Now friends, I will tell you one very interesting fact, that द थिंग विच आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू जस्ट नाउ एक्चुअली इट हैड ऑलरेडी हैपन्ड इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया. ओके सो द थिंग विच आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू जस्ट नाउ. ओके सो दिस हैज ऑलरेडी हैपन्ड इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया बट एक्चुअली दिस इज यूट्यूब सो आई कैन नॉट टेक एनी नेम्स एंड आई हैव ऑल्सो मॉडिफाइड द स्टोरी लिटिल बिट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द करेंट provisions of the constitution. Okay, because the provisions of the constitution have also changed from that time, because that time provisions of the constitution were different and now the provisions of the constitution are different. So I have modified this story to make you understand the cons or demerits of prime ministerial form of government according to present constitutional provisions. Okay, so this had already happened in the history of India, but I cannot take any names and I cannot tell you the names and the entire story which happened at that point of time, because definitely you can understand that this is YouTube, so this is an open platform. So here I have to teach within limits. Okay, so if this was our private classroom, then I could have told you much more than this. So friends, now let's move further. Now friends, what is the third demerit or what is the third con of the prime ministerial form of government? So friends, now it is your assignment, it is your homework to think and to search that what is the next demerit of the prime ministerial form of government. And you have to send me the answers on the Instagram. My Instagram ID is PrashantIS7. Okay. And I will announce the name of all those students who will give the correct answer. So now what is your homework? Your homework is to search, to think for the third demerit of the prime ministerial form of government. So friends, that's all for today. Now we will meet in next class. Friends, I hope that you all must have enjoyed the lecture, and if you have enjoyed the lecture, then please like the video, comment, subscribe the channel, press the bell icon, select all, and share this channel to all the people you know who are preparing for UPSC. Now we will meet in next class. Till then, take care of yourself. Thank you.